again. I'm Henry T. Welcome to the show that emphatically spells out inspiration. We get hundreds of stories that come from all around the state of New Mexico, Colorado, Texas, and a little bit of Arizona as well. If you have one, by the way, call me here at KZQ-TV32 at 884-8355. Today, we're going to be inspired by my high school football coach, former star football player at the University of New Mexico. I mean, a great one. All-conference for the Lobos back in the day. He hails from Austin, Texas, of all places. He gave me a little bit of his Texas accent when he first came off the football field at UNM and came over to Sandia High School. He's a Hall of Fame, National Hall of Fame inductee into the Wrestling Referees Organization. Did I don't know how many wrestling matches, and did them on the big time level, and owns a state high school football championship, 1977. I mean, 76. It goes on and on and on. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
On a great career.
Boy, you always make it sound so great. You know, it wasn't quite that good, but, you know, I had a great time doing a lot of good things that I love doing, and, you know, I'm still doing as best I can.
And hit a home run when you met a young, pretty lady from Roswell, New Mexico, Diana.
Bred and born, bred in New Mexican, all the way.
My goodness, that was a grand slam.
Yes. And you know what? I'm still with her 51 years later, so something was right. You know,
unbelievable. And, should we give her
our condolences? She put up with me for 51 years so far. That's amazing.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Coach, you've always had that special disposition. All your former players, like myself, we love you. We have respect for you. You taught us how to be rough and tough on that football field, but you always were there when we needed you. You know, sometimes you can't take problems to mom and dad.
Oh, yeah.
Some of those,
right.
We took them to Coach Ottman.
Well,
Coach,
you know, that's some of the responsibilities of any coach, is to be able to, you know, take care of his kids, you know, and teach them the ways of, way to do things, the way of life, and hope you do the right thing when you tell them. But, you know, we always had, every coach that I've ever known has an open ear, an open door for every one of his players to come in, no matter when, whether they've graduated. And, you know, I still talk to, you know, several of the players over the years that are 60, 65 years old and things like this. And it's always, you always have an open mind, open ear to your former players.
Coach, let's back up all the way. You were inspired early on in your life. Mom and Dad said, Jimmy, you can be somebody. You can be successful. This is what you do. How did Mom and Dad inspire Coach Jim Ottman?
Well, you know, probably one thing, they were good people. You know, they were good, honest, hardworking Americans back in those days. And you know, my dad worked awfully hard. He was a traveling shoe salesman, so he worked awfully hard. And, you know, it was things that they did that they provided for my sister and myself, you know, as well as they could. And we always lived, you know, comfortably, but not, you know, not eloquent in any way it means. But so my dad instilled there, and plus he was an athlete. He loved sports. Back then they didn't have everything, but he played some baseball in semi-pro leagues, and he was a bowler, heck of a good bowler. So he loved athletics, and he understood it. And he always tried to move me in that direction, thinking that the same thing would happen to me, and it did. You know, I loved sports and athletics from as far back as I can remember. And we started back then usually as 8-year-old in Little League Baseball. That's about the only thing they had. And Little League Baseball was very new back in 19...
what? Was Dad your first coach?
Dad was my first coach, yeah. Coached me in baseball, in Little League Baseball.
Yeah.
And naturally, my attitude about it had to be the catcher. Catchers get involved with everything. They're the basically the captains of the team out on the field.
You know? Yeah.
You know, they run the pitcher, they put everybody in spot, and I had to be the catcher because you got dirty and, you know, and things like this. And so that's the position I stayed most all the way through, through high school and junior college. So. And that's
how about your first experience as a football player in Austin, Texas? Did they have Pop Warner football or anything like
that?
No,
back then, you know, Austin, Texas was a great place to grow up. They had a lot of things for kids to do, and I'm sure they still do now. They had parks. They had community parks everywhere. It was everything free to the kids. We played baseball, we played softball, we played tag football, touch football, and you know, we played volleyball, we swam, we played tennis. We played all kinds of games in this park, and the whole neighborhood would come, and we'd really have a good time. Saturday and Sunday, that's where we always were, all day. You know, I'd just leave in the morning, go to the park, do our thing, come back in time for dinner. I know nowadays you can't call it do that, but that's what we always did. So we played flag football. And then they had football in was in ninth grade.
Coach, so, Bill Weeks, the former Lobo football coach, he's looking for players here at the University of New Mexico. He finds you in Austin, Texas. Did he fly there and recruit you one-on-one? How did they find Jim Ottman to come to Albuquerque?
That's a kind of a nice story, but and not too many people know it, but I've told a few people around. Back in 1959, there was an all-star junior college football game here in Albuquerque at University Stadium.
Wow.
It lasted 2 years. And after high school, I went to junior college, Navarro Junior College in Corsicana, Texas, because of some grade difficulties. I wasn't eligible to go anywhere else. I was in junior college. But I got smarter after that.
I figured out
if I was going to play athletics, I had to get smart. So I took care of all that after I got out here. But my junior college coach was the coach for that all-star team. And he told, it wasn't Bill Weeks, it was Marv Levy. He told Marv Levy, I've got a football player on my squad whose mother and dad had just moved to Albuquerque that might be interested in playing for the Lobos after next year. I had one more year in junior college. And so Marv Levy contacted me and got me out of there without going back for that extra year. And sight unseen, all he was doing is going by what my coach said, that maybe this kid could play for you guys. And back then I was a big kid, 200 pounder was a big kid in 1959.
You know, yeah.
Especially as a fullback. So since mother and dad were here, I just said, I'm going there now. And then Bill Weeks took over for Levy that summer. So Bill Weeks and his staff had never seen me play ever. They hadn't, all they talked was to Marv Levy, said, hey, this guy's coming from Corsicana. Never seen him play. We don't know what the heck he can do. And so I've been here ever since.
Great move.
That's amazing. Yeah, it was a great move because my junior college team went 1-9 the year I didn't go back.
Wow.
That was the problem. I was the only offensive starter that was a freshman. And so everybody graduated. And don't they?
What a story.
That's a good thing. Probably a good thing I moved out here.
Well, when you suited up for the Lobos right away, you were a starter, never left that position. You were a great fullback, all-conference defensive back. Your Lobos led the country in defensive stats, as I recall.
As my junior year, we led the country in pass defense, and I was a halfback.
Yeah.
We didn't have cornerbacks. They were halfbacks.
Oh.
Halfbacks. So, they get fancy when they went to – we played both ways. So the only time they got fancy is when they started two-platooning. So we could call them cornerbacks, and you could call them wideouts. We called them split ends, you know. But nobody ever split out in the wing T.
Unbelievable.
So it was
well,
funny.
We love playing for you. You won a state championship 1976 with a running back named Mike Carter, Phil Trent.
Yep.
And tell us about that experience, because, hey, state championships are rare.
Especially for Albuquerque people.
Amen.
You know, I was a special group of kids who loved to play football and had the ability to play it pretty well. You know, it was Mike Carter and Phil Trent and Jeff Alloway. God, I can name Dave Pinnell or Steve Pinnell. And, I still hear from those kids quite a bit. I haven't heard from Phil lately, but that's a great success story there. And I'm on Facebook with Mike Carter and a lot of those players. I'm on Facebook with probably 30 or 40 ex-Sandia football players. And so I try to keep in contact. I really love hearing from those guys and this, that, and the other. But Those two were special players, and I had some special players. It makes you a better coach when you hand the ball off to a Mike Carter. You know, who can run a 9 400-yard dash and weighs about 185 pounds, and he's gone, you know. But that was a special group of kids. We were state champs in 76 and state runner-up in 77. And those kids all turned out to be just great kids.
You get a little
great
emotional.
Adults.
You get a little emotional when you think about those great players,
those
special friends that happen to be your players.
Yeah,
it meant a lot to you, didn't it?
It did, and it still does. It still does. All of them. I mean, I still keep score at the basketball games at Sandia High School. That's 20 years after I retired. Matter of fact, I have one this afternoon or tonight, and see a lot of former players who kids are playing now at Sandia or playing at La Cueva or do something like that. So I see a lot of those kids that I can't remember their names, all of them, but faces I remember, and they'll come up and say, "Hi, coach. I played for you in 1968."
You've done so many things.
How do you remember people like that?
Wow, impossible. You've coached thousands of us.
Thousands.
Former players.
And students.
Wow.
I walked into a doctor's office the other day, and the doctor was a former student. You know, so Mike Melizzo is my back doctor now. He's a former running back.
My goodness.
Melizzo. So I see a lot of them. It's really great. And you know, I see you all the time, too. You're a former great one, too. That's an inspirational story. Anybody could play as many sports as you did without being able to see was really good.
That's a story. When we come back, we'll share. They didn't have contact lenses, LASIK surgery in those days.
Not they didn't.
But they did have Coke bottles.
That's
Thank
right.
God, huh? Anyway, we have a lot to talk about. Former all-world broadcaster Jim Ottman as well. And we have some experiences we want to share with you. When we come back here on KZQ Channel 32, stay right there.
Funding for today's programming has been provided in part by
A&D Heating and Air Conditioning.
Hi, my name is Aaron, and I am the owner of A&D Heating and Air Conditioning. I am an avid listener of Channel 32, and this is our brand, A&D Signature Series.
A&D also provides repairs, new installations, evaporative to refrigerated conversions, and other services. A&D Heating and Air Conditioning, 505-489-9342.
Thanks for supporting family programming.
Funding for today's programming has been brought to you in part by
Marty Seiss, a local State Farm insurance agent.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those.
We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
Marty Seiss, 345-3431. Thank you for supporting family programming.
again. I'm Henry T. Welcome to the show about inspiration. And today, our special inspiration leader is my high school football coach, Jim Ottman. And coach, we've done so many things together. Not only did I play for you.
Yes, you did.
We broadcast thousands of football games together.
I don't know whether it was a thousand, but it was a bunch in all kind of weather, in all kind of places, on the top of the bleachers, on under the bleachers, edge of the bleachers, standing up, sitting down,
wherever.
Walking.
We've traveled the state.
Everywhere.
We've been to Clovis a few times together.
It was so cold in Clovis, the hot chocolate froze. You know what I mean? Golly, we've been freezing to death. Oh, man, we've been lightning.
That's not exaggerating.
I know. Struck by lightning, you know, melted our equipment. You sent me, this was your fault this time. You sent me to Laguna Acoma to broadcast a game back to Clayton.
Yeah.
To Clayton. I had to do it on my cell phone. I didn't have a phone. I didn't have any equipment, so I did it on my cell phone.
Improvised.
No program.
Improvisation.
No program, because Laguna didn't have programs. I had no idea who anybody was.
And the names.
No names. I didn't have any
names. The names are difficult to pronounce.
It's just, now, number 12, a quarterback, he hands the ball off to number 24. I don't know who these guys are. You sent me. You did that to me. You made me all the way out to Laguna.
How about tonight, ladies and gentlemen? It's lightning, bad thunder, lightning over Wilson Stadium. We're at the top of the press box. Lightning hits our press box. Yes. What happened?
Everything melted. Luckily, except you and I. But, boy, I threw those headset off because it was loud. It was a bang. And you did the same thing. And, we were scared. We got out of there pretty quick.
Yeah.
But our equipment, our little box with all the things on it, melted. So it was
ruined.
It was amazing that we survived that. You know, that and the rides to Clovis and wherever. But it was all fun. We had a big time doing it. I really enjoyed working with you, you know, and doing the color on those games, even though we didn't know who the players were some of the time. We did it anyhow.
And it was fun.
It was fun.
And on a couple of occasions going to Clovis, I didn't know country music, and I got to love country music because of my coach, Jim Ottman. We're listening to Johnny Rodriguez on the way to Clovis, New Mexico, a few of those times.
Yeah.
And we got pulled over a couple of times, coach, because we were running
late. Well, I remember three, and two of them we got tickets. The third one, we should have got put in jail, but... the guy happened to be a Clovis ex-football player, and we were going to Clovis to do the game against Del Norte, and he let us go. He didn't give us a ticket. We were only going 105 or something like that. I probably shouldn't have mentioned that, but that was 20, 30 years ago, so they won't give us any trouble now.
No, too late to give us a ticket.
We were late.
Yeah.
We were late to the reason.
And he kind of gave us a little escort into Clovis from there.
And once he caught us.
But that was fun. We did hundreds and hundreds of games together. And with your great voice, I mean, I had no hesitation to say, I'm tired, Coach Ottman, take over.
Yeah. We did many a time. We did them a lot of places.
Yeah.
Little places, big places.
By the way, Coach is one of the inductees. He's one of the inductees into the New Mexico Sports Hall of Fame, and as a player, as a coach, as a referee, as a broadcaster, I mean, your resume is long.
I like to keep busy, so I love doing those things.
And a great amateur golfer on top of it all.
Well, I was. You know, as I get older, I'm not great at much anything, but, you know, I still like to do it.
Yeah.
And I don't like to sit around much, and I like to keep busy. And I just want to mention here, this New Mexico Sports Hall of Fame was great. I really, you know, enjoy that and take that really as a great compliment to the efforts that I put in. But you did this too. I want people to know that coming in here in February or April 12th or something like that, April 3rd. Well, I'll be there anyhow. That you're going to be inducted in, and that's going to be great. I think that's super and probably should have been done several years ago. So congratulations to you, too.
Thank you.
I'm going to be there, and I'm going to cheer and, you know, and see you inducted. That'll be something special for me, too, as a former player and colleague, broadcast colleague.
Thank you, Coach. Say.
That's neat.
You know, you've come through some hard times physically. All athletes do.
Oh, yeah.
But you had some major back operations, and your leisure time activity, which is enjoying golf, that was a question mark there for a while. Tell us about how you came through that physical dilemma.
Well, it's just like, you know, if you're an athlete, you know, you just live with that type of stuff, you know. And when, you know, you want to inspire people, just do what you want to do and do it all the time. You know, I still hurt. My back hurts. I've had two fusions in my neck and a back operation, and I got a little sciatica. And golf is the worst thing you can do, and it hurts a little bit. And sometimes I just have to back away. But if I stop doing it, what's going to happen? Am I going to rot away, or, you know, because I can't walk too far anyhow. But so I just continue doing what I want to do, you know, and stay as busy as I can doing the things I love doing. That's sports. So I keep score at Sandia High School. I've done a couple, three or four low bowl games. I'm the backup low bowl scorekeeper.
Amen.
And I do the state basketball tournament down at the pit. And I work the track meets. I do the long triple jump for APS at their track meets.
Wow.
And I'll play golf.
My
goodness. And go to my granddaughter. My little granddaughter, Riley, she's a basketball player. Inspires me all the time, you know. She go get some. She's a go-getter type, hustle all the time, you know. And, you know, I go watch her play and get fired up again.
That old expression, behind every great man is an even greater woman. How did you find Diana? How did you get blessed with such a terrific
wife? I'm trying to think. You know, I don't really...
Was it love at first sight?
Well, probably, because we never went with anybody else after that. Trying to think, one of her girlfriends and Pi Phi sorority sisters dated another football player, and we got together and had a blind date, double date type deal to go to the laundromat. And so so that's where we went. Our first day was to the laundromat. So,
wow.
That was quite interesting. And, you know, after that, I don't think either one of us dated anybody else. So we've been together for 54, 55 years, something
My
like that.
Goodness.
And it's amazing. Bless her heart. You know, she put up a lot with a football coach, an athlete, and a busy guy. You know, she has to have a special place there herself.
She was with us on many, many of our games
that we broadcast. Yeah, she's a goer too. She doesn't like to sit around too much. And she has her own thing, and I have my own thing, and we probably get along better that way.
Amen.
You know, she probably couldn't take me 24/7, you know what I mean?
Amateur golf, it's a big part of your life. And ladies and gentlemen, he's so accomplished with trophies scattered all over the place. And not long ago, a scratch golfer. And maybe if you'd have found a sponsor, you'd have been on the senior tour of the PGA.
Well, I don't know about that. You know, I often wondered when I was about 45 years old or so to give up what I was doing and try. Because it takes practice. You just can't walk out there and do it. You know, some people think they can. But I figured I'd need at least three years of complete concentration on golf to even have a shot at it. But, you know, I like doing other things too. You know, I loved the coaching part of it, and I wasn't ready to give that up. So, you know, I'm a pretty good golfer, but, you know, nothing special, especially now. You know, but I love to play, and it's something I can do without hurting too much.
Yeah.
I was a Golf Digest course rater for years. I just retired from that. So I got to play some awfully nice golf courses around the country, the Pebble Beaches.
My goodness.
You know, in Orlando, Bay Hills and Doral's and a couple places all over the country. And so that was a great experience. Really enjoyed playing at those places. Got a little expensive, and you have to walk. And walking some of those.
As we conclude our interview, kids have always been special to you.
Yeah.
You've given your heart and soul and life to kids through all of your professions.
Right. Working with kids and being around kids,
What have they done for you, Coach? How has this career inspired you as a man?
Well, they're young. They're usually enthusiastic. They're fun to be around. And you know, I just like people, be around people that do that. I don't like to be around people who sit in chairs, you know, and watch television and play in the garden or something like this. I like to be out and about.
Amen.
And I like, and young people do that. They got a lot of enthusiasm. They got a lot of energy. And I like for that to run off on me, and I love to see them and how well they've done, like yourself, how successful they've been. And boy, I got a ton of kids out there that have been a lot of success. And how could you have possibly done that? You know, Coach, well, I just, that's something I wanted to do, and I went. You know, I have a story that one of the doctors that I had for when I had a little problem with my leg, he comes into the to his office there to examine me. And he's got his back to him, and he's typing on his computer, and he says, are you the same Coach Ottman that made me run all those laps and do all those push-ups and all those things, and you yelled at me for 3 years? Are you that Coach Ottman? And I can't remember this kid. He graduated in 64, 1964. And he's just a little bit, because that's the job. Yeah, I guess. Well, who are you? He says, I'm little bitty itty McBeatty, you called me, because he's a small guy. And he said, you name me little bitty itty bitty. So, you know, I see things like that naturally. You know, it's just an inspiration to me to see those kids and see how well they're doing and what they're doing. I've got doctors, lawyers, I've got people. Well, one of them was an Indian chief even, and you know, I see them everywhere. And it just, so good, so nice to be able to.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, what an honor to be in here today with Coach Jim Ottman, football coach, Sandia High School. And he taught me a few things out there in that football field that inspired me, that I'll never forget, that I'm indebted to this man for many, many of those special moments that an athlete goes through with the coaches and the players. I thank you.
Well, thank you for having me,
Coach.
You bet. Wow. Thank you. It's always good to be with you. You know that. You and I could talk for 100 years, I think.
Yeah. Hey, our greatest days are in front of us.
I hope so, because I'm still going to be here to do them.
Amen.
Yep. Okay.
Play-by-play has never been the same since Coach and I got out there in that broadcast booth. What a pleasure it is to be with my high school football coach, Jim Ottman, today, right here on KZQ Channel 32. Tune in tomorrow morning, and we'll have even more inspiration for you right here on the home of inspiration, KZQ Channel 32. You got a story, don't forget to call me with it, 907-4523, or email originalgameface@gmail.com. It's been great talking with you today, right here on KZQ. Remember, we're on every morning right here. Be inspired with Henry T, 8 o'clock on KZQ, Channel 32.
Funding for today's programming has been brought to you in part by
Malloy Dodge, Albuquerque's new and used Dodge and Ram truck dealer since 1955.
I'm Nick Malloy from Malloy Dodge. For four generations, we've been serving thousands of New Mexicans from all across our fine state. Over 65 years of trust, our family serving yours. Malloy Dodge, we're proud to stand behind our community.
Thank you for supporting family programming.